My name is Gail Honeycutt, and I was actually born in LaGrange and have lived in this house since I was a child. It was built in 1853 and 54. My parents bought it in 47. At the time, it was not occupied. And I don't remember it, but my older brother remembers coming over here on a rainy, cold Sunday afternoon. And our daddy said, "This is the house we think we're going to buy." They came to the front door and opened the door, and it was dark, it was cold, it was gloomy, it was gray. There was very little color in here. And my brother said, "Oh no, surely we're not moving here." But we did, and it's not dark, cold, gloomy, or gray anymore. As a child, I remember Mother would go around all the time and straighten pictures because there was a traffic light right out there. And the big 18-wheelers would come through, and if the traffic light caught them, they would stop. And then you know what happens when 18-wheelers start up. And that would be enough to jar pictures, and that would wiggle around. So we don't have the big transfer trucks coming through down, and they took down the light. But normal traffic has greatly increased. We fought Wyden and Vernon for years. We fought commercial encroachment and development on De Vernon for years. My family fought it, my parents fought it, and now my husband and I are fighting it. But the traffic is the biggest change. The houses around here haven't changed at all. There are a lot of older houses in town that the Yankees and Sherman's group did not burn. But the local citizens, in our great wisdom, we have managed to tear down many, many more houses than the Northern Union Army probably would have burned. We were the first young family to move back on this street. Now, we're the old folks, but we're starting to get younger families that are moving into the neighborhood, which is really, really good. And we like to see big wheels in the driveways. To understand why families built old houses, that always represented the lifestyle of that particular era, of that particular neighborhood, of that particular group of people. And it's just an insight into how life was. In my opinion, to preserve the history preserves your past, and you have not a lot of future. You don't know, none of us know what the future holds, but if you don't understand the past and appreciate the past, then you really don't have a path to the future.